All right, it's the end of the session. I'm here with my buddy Coco, who it took quite a while to relax. She's a fearful dog. I think her guardians have, due to COVID and some other issues, she was not able to get a lot of socialization experience when she was a puppy. And I think that lack of socialization experience, if I could say that properly, has led to some insecurities. That insecurities is now manifested in what is perceived as an aggressive behavior, barking and lunging at things she doesn't like people getting up and moving around or people on walks. I think this is a defense technique that the dog is using because when she barks and lunges, people tend to move away or leave the home. And so it's her way of coping with the situation, and it also validates her. So the video above kind of talks about how we can reverse that by recreating the situation the dog doesn't do a good job in, or where the behavior is not what we want, and then basically rearranging it so it's so the dog gets rewarded for that behavior actually happening. Coco, are you gonna dance? I just want to keep her in the shot, and her parents went inside. We don't have a fenced-in backyard, so you got to stay up here for a little while. All right, so basically, we started off by talking about exercise. Sit. That's celebrate. We're not to that point yet, Coco. So she's not a huge dog. She's probably not a super high-energy dog, but she definitely needs more exercise than she's getting. The guardians right now are taking her for a one long walk, where it's really, and they don't like to walk her a lot because she reacts to other dogs. So we went over some creative forms of exercise. The doggy Stairmaster, scent games, which is one where you hide treats around. You can Google scent games. There's a lot of examples for that. I'd like to play fetch with her, but she doesn't drop. Now, the way to do that was when she's got something in her mouth, I would pull out a treat, Coco, and I just hold it here. I wouldn't say anything. She's going to try to take it while the object's in her mouth. And then as soon as she drops the object, I put her mouth, I say the word drop, and then I don't pick the object up. So you want to do this with what we call low value items, her toys and things she's allowed to have at any point. And then eventually you get to the point where she has something she's not allowed to have. You say drop, she spits it out, because that means I'm going to get something good. Now, if you do have to take the item away, we'd call that a trade. So I would have two treats, hold the first, or tell her to drop. When she drops, put the first one in her mouth, and I throw a treat over here. The dog goes over to get it. The object is still, hey Coco, let's hang out here, sweetheart. The object's still here, so I throw a treat to get the dog to move away, and when it moves away, I pick up the object. But at that point, we want to make sure that we give her something of equal or greater value, like a bully stick or something along those lines. Other forms of exercise, scent games, like as I Google that, but also using her nose. So on walks, make sure you let her sniff as much as she wants to, as long as it's safe to do so. I'd also recommend getting an Omega paw treat ball, probably a medium or large size for her, filling up with some of her kibble, some of the treats that I left with the tricky trainers, and then putting it on the floor and letting it roll around. So it's a nice way for her to earn her food, burn some energy, gain some confidence, and it's very relaxing and very beneficial. I'd also order one of those snuffle mats. The one that you saw in the video that I showed you is the first one you'll see when you search for snuffle mat on Amazon. And I would highly recommend that. That way, when we feed her, she's actually getting a little bit of exercise and stimulation for an activity that she's going to do every day anyways. Can we hang out for a little bit longer? I promise I'm going to let you go. But I don't want to let you go right now because there's nobody else to watch you. So the idea is, remember, when she is misbehaving or barking and lunging, ask yourself how long has it been since she's been exercised. The sooner you make the realization that her unwanted behavior is often tied to or a result of lack of exercise, the more healthy you're going to feel about the situation. So it's just like a mother doesn't say, my child is being naughty, my child is tired and needs a nap. So I want you to look at the same mindset. So we want to figure out how much exercise she needs for various things. So remember, exercise should be done with an empty stomach. And the first time, do the treat toss up and down the stairs and keep on doing it until she won't do it anymore. Remember, use those fun command words we talked about. And I have a video on the doggy Stairmaster and the rest of the stuff if you forget how to do that. But she'll throw the treat at the bottom of the stairs. She licks it up, say, Jamaica. Sure, you have another one. She comes to the top and give her that one and call it Canada. Count each down up as one. And keep doing this until she won't go down there anymore when you know she's hungry. So we know what her maximum number is. And you play around with the digits, but usually you want to exercise the dog about 50 to 75% of that maximum number. You can exercise her before things happen. Before you're going to take her for a walk, exercise her. Maybe she needs 15 up-downs on the stairs. Before a guest comes over, maybe she needs 22. Maybe before we vacuum, she needs 5. So the idea is to come up with something that's reasonable that you guys can do where you can achieve, put her in a position to succeed. Like I said, there's other forms of exercise that you can do, but I would try to focus on those and come up with a rhythm or routine. And exercise for a dog like hers is going to be best accomplished about every 3 or 4 hours in short little spurts. All right, I'll let you get down, but I'm gonna have to step on the leash, and you're gonna have to stay right around in this area. All right, so let's see, other things that we went over. We went over dog psychology, and I'm gonna kind of encapsulate it, some of the highlights. So anything a dog is doing when you pet it is what you're specifically rewarding, including unbalanced states of mind like fear, stress, and anxiety. So if she's nervous, you can lay your hand on Coco, and that's assuring, but don't start petting her because that'll make her more nervous. Whenever you do pet her, try to avoid petting on top of the head. Creates a down nose orientation. Insecures dogs have the nose down. All things being equal, pet under the chin so that nose is up. Let me see, what else? Any attention to a dog is validating. So she's barking and you try to correct her, which you shouldn't do, and I'll explain why in a minute, but she looks at that correction as validating. Now, if a dog is reacting or growling at something, that's the antithesis of aggression, saying, I disagree with that. If we punish or don't listen to the dog or force them to submit, then it's just validating their perception. So anytime your dog's growling, what we want to do is increase the distance between them and whatever the thing is, or recreate the situation like I talked about in the video above to help extinguish the behavior so the dog sees the arrival of a new person as a good positive thing as opposed to something to bark at. All right, I'd also like the guardians to, some more dog psychology stuff. So anything that the dog does in your presence that you don't disagree with is it looked at as having your seal of approval. And that's kind of how dogs learn. They probe waiting for you to say no. So if we're not paying attention, they probe and they break a boundary and we don't correct them for it, that really confuses them. So you want to create situations where you can help the dog practice the behavior that he wants. Yes, I know. I want to be done too. But we want to help them practice the behavior we want and reward them for doing so. So the video above does a really good job of explaining that. Yes, I know. It's so tough to be a Coco, isn't it? Yes, Coco girl. Come here, girl. Come here. It's like, no, you're always on your lap for too long. Okay, I'd like the guardians, they kennel Coco right now, and no dog should ever be in a kennel for longer than 4 hours except for sleeping overnight. And so what I'd like the guardians to do is get an X pen, letter X, P-E-N, probably one that's about 30 or 36 inches tall, make sure it has a doorway to it, and set it up in a little room so that when you do have to go to a friend's house or run an errand, you're not putting her in the kennel because all she does right now is bark in the kennel, and that's what she's practicing doing, freaking out in the kennel. So she should spend time in the long-term confinement area, that's what we call that, at times when you're home, just on the other side of the fence. You give her a bully stick, let her sit in there, and then you sit next to her watching TV. So she practices being calm in that area, and if she has the bully stick, something she likes, she gets some practice at doing that and enjoying it. And then that becomes the place that you can leave her in there. Now, because she probably is going to want to climb out of it, make sure it's tall enough so that she, if she goes to the fence, she can't, definitely can't get her paws over the top of it. And then you can get some light gauge PVC pipe and cut it along one axis so it's like a C. And then you put the C as a cap on the top of the of each of the 8 sections. That way, when she tries to climb over it, she doesn't get a grip and she won't be able to escape. But if she's not chewing or destroying anything, then I would probably let her out. Now, the guardians talked about her potentially having separation anxiety, but she's so fearful right at this point, I really want the guardians to focus on the stuff we're going over this video to build up her self-esteem and confidence. Now, one of the things I did do towards the end of the session is I gave the guardians a clicker and went through the basics of clicker training. So I would like you to actually go to YouTube, find some dog tricks and commands. Remember, the click is when she does the right thing. So if you're teaching her to sit, when her butt hits the ground, that's when you click and they give her the treat and say the word sit. So the more skills that a dog has, the more confidence they have. And confidence allows you to brush things off. So what I'd like you to do is try to pick a new trick or command each week for 4 consecutive weeks and have a different member of the house teach it to her. And so she actually learns the new tricks and commands and boosts that self-esteem and confidence. Now, we also talked about some rules. Sit. So the rules that we have are, first of all, not being around the furniture. And for dogs, it's not so much, all right, I'll put you back up here. For the rules, for dogs, the furniture, it's not so much being sitting in this chair or that chair, it's the height, remember. So order those X mats, get one for every furniture cushion she wants to go on. And then basically you can, you put those there and that'll help keep her off the chair, the orange chair as you guys refer to it. But you probably need to put it in other places as well. I have a video on teaching a dog to go to the dog bed, so if she keeps on trying to get on the furniture, let me know. The X mats should take care of it, but I have a video that I can share with you that she teaches her to want to go to the dog bed. Anytime we take away the furniture, I always like to give them the dog bed at the same time. You're like ants in the pants, but I need you to sit here quietly for another couple minutes and we'll wrap this sucker up, I promise. So I'd also like you to, like I said, feed her, make sure that you guys are eating something before you feed her. And you complete your meal first. All it takes is 5 bites of something. A chip, cracker, piece of celery, whatever it is, breakfast bar. Oh boy, are you a dancer. And then eventually, okay, well I can put you down, but you were complaining. There we go. All right, And don't, if she's ever wiggling, don't let her go when she's wiggling, because that looks as a validation. So anytime I don't want something, I just wiggle till I get free. So wait for her to stop wiggling, then put her down. And that way you're rewarding. That's kind of like the It's Your Choice game that I showed you, that I want you guys to do. So that, remember for that. So if this is dog's nose, I have a bunch of treats in my hand. As soon as it backs away, I open my hand, it goes for it, I close my hand. It licks, paws, does all this stuff, nothing happens. Backs away, my hand opens, goes for it continually until eventually it goes away and you open your hand, it stays there. Then I take one treat with my hand and I give it to the dog. So what I'm saying is if you try to take it, nothing happens, you won't win. But as soon as you stop trying to take it, I will give you one. Now first, as soon as she backs away, take it and give it to her. Then after you hold it and keep it open for 1 second, then you give her the treat. And then after you get that 3 or 4 times, then maybe you hold it open for 2 seconds if you're not trying to get it. And do that until you work your way up to about 5-7 seconds. And do it in different parts of your house and have everybody in the family that wants to participate do that, because it's a great way for her to practice a little impulse control. Just because I want something doesn't mean I get it. I have to wait and be patient for my humans to give it to me. Okay, we also talked about, so getting back to rules, you have to sit at the door. Go to the door, say sit one time. If she doesn't sit within 3 seconds, walk away, sit down, wait 1 minute, come back to the door, command her again to sit only one time. If she doesn't sit this time, I walk away for 2 minutes, sitting down. Next time I sit down for 4 minutes, then for 8 minutes, I keep doubling the length of time till when I say sit, she sits, and then as soon as she does, the door flies open. So the door flying open becomes the reward. So you might have your tether through the door. So as soon as she sits down, you can reach down and attach it, or maybe you attach it first and give her a little bit of leeway. So don't have it just a short one. So bring a little bit of the cord inside the house, close it. The door's closed, so she's attached to it. She's kind of near the door. And then sit down, wait for that 1 minute. When you go back to the door, tell her to sit. If she sits, you open the door. She's already attached. She can run out and have a good time. So eventually, she has to sit before every door to open it. I'd also make her sit every time you cross the street on walks. Make her sit before you pick up the leash to put her take her on a walk. Not let her have food. So put the food down. So imagine this is the food bowl and this is the dog. So I put the bowl down. She starts going for it. I put my hand on top of it. She backs away. I raise my hand. Kind of like the It's Your Choice game that we went until eventually she backs away. I pull my hand up. She stays there. Pull it all the way. And then I invite her to come and eat. So there's nothing blocking her other than respect for your authority. Okay, other rules, she shouldn't be in the kitchen when you're preparing food, and she shouldn't be near you when you're eating. Even if she's not begging, her presence is inappropriate. To be within 7 feet of anyone who's eating or has a high-value item is inappropriate in the dog world. It's a way of challenging for that item. I have a video on my website, Invisible or Kitchen, you can search for, and it shows you how to teach your dog to stay behind an invisible line or out of the kitchen. Now, to do those, just go to dogonproblems.com and click on where it says Dog Training Tips. Type in the search box on the top of the page or the bottom of the page if you're on a phone or computer. Invisible. And videos, write-ups will come up with videos of me showing you how to enforce a visible line. Sit. All right, so she just sat. That's passive training. Passive training is waiting for the dog to organically offer the behavior. So every time she comes to you, I want you to pet her and say, come. Every time she sits, I want you to pet her and say, sit. Remember, pet under the chin and say, sit. Not sit. Every time she lays down, pet her and say, crash or chill or whatever your word is. So what we're doing is we're rewarding her for the things that she does that we like when she does them on her own. We're not asking her to sit. We're just rewarding her when she does the action. And eventually we could say, sit, and she sits down right away because she knows that means I'm going to get a treat. I remember I asked you guys what she could do to make you happy, and you guys struggled. Now, after a month of this, sit. She's like, they like it when I sit, when I come, when I lay down. I know. Yeah, she's being feisty now. She wants to go inside. So I would do it every time she takes her bite of food. Call it chimichanga or pasta or sushi or whatever it is. Every time she takes her first bite of food for 4 months, you say sushi. After I say sushi, that means I get to go eat. Name all your individual toys. All balls can be balls, all bones can be bones. But if she has a little elephant, call it Trump, a little zebra, you call it ref or whatever it is. Come up with fun names. Remember, try to come up with fun names for all the future commands. And so passive training is just celebrating the thing dogs does that we like when it does it on its own, and we're celebrating and rewarding it within that 3 second window. So make sure that you use the watchword celebrate. So if I'm sitting here watching TV and Coco walks up to me, somebody says celebrate, I turn and I start petting her as fast as I can, then I identify, what did she just do? Oh, she's standing there, so she probably just came to me. So I would pet her and say, come. If she's sitting, it's pretty obvious. So the idea is to reward her for the things you want, and she will start emulating those behaviors to ask for or get your attention. Now, before that, we talked about petting with a purpose. And the petting with a purpose usually is because the dog's nudging the guardians for attention. In her case, she gets petted so much she doesn't have to ask for it. I think she's a little bit spoiled in this regard. So if you want to pet her, Coco, sit. Sit. So I raised my hand. If I arc my hand over the head of the dog, that kind of, as they raise their head up to get more, to track it, they'll put their butt down. As soon as their butt hits down, I lower down and I tickle under their chin. Sometimes I let them lick a treat off my hand, but I always tickle. So that way it always becomes a reward. So when she comes, so right now, if you want to pet her, if you tell her to sit, she doesn't sit, and you pet her anyways, then she wins. She just gets what she wants for, I don't say she wins, but she gets what she wants. So instead, tell her to sit one time. If she doesn't sit, within 3 seconds, lean back, pull out your phone, check out some emails, watch TV, talk to the wife, do some other things. So let her know that I wanted to pet you, I wanted to give you my attention. But if you can't be bothered to do what I asked you to do, then I don't give you any attention. And I'm on to the next thing, and it's no bother for me. Now the dog is the one that's shorted. And after a while, the dog will recognize, if I want attention from them, I have to sit to prepay for the attention. And when she does that, make sure you pet her, because that's adopting a more desirable behavior. You pet her under her chin and say the word sit, and pet her as much or as little as you want. If she doesn't sit, like I said, she misses out on that opportunity. You show her you're living your best life with other things. After a while, she'll start prepaying for that, and that's a great transition. Make sure you use the watchword of paycheck if you suspect someone's petting without a purpose. So if I'm petting her when she's standing, somebody says paycheck, even if I did it right, I would stop petting, tell her to sit, sit. She didn't sit there, but normally I would sit, pet and then say sit if she sat. And then turn to the person and say, actually I asked her to sit. When you opened the door, she stood up and I continued petting, but thank you, because I do forget to pet without a purpose. It's a gentle reminder, not a gotcha. I say celebrate is my way to remind somebody, hey, you're missing an opportunity to reward the dog for a desired behavior. I also say vocabulary if you're using the wrong word. If I'm saying, come here, come here, come here, come here, over here, come here, girl. Well, the word is come. So I'm saying, come here. Somebody says vocabulary, I'm like, come. It's much easier for the dog to understand if you only say the word once. Now, I really say it twice. So if she's right here, you can't see her. But if I'd say, Coco, sit, sit. So I told her what to do. When she did it, then I petted her after to tell her. Now, if she doesn't know how to do it, what I would do is I would hold a treat and I manipulate it so that she kind of sits down. As soon as she achieves it, I put the treat in her mouth and I would say the word sit, unless I'm using a clicker. Then I would manipulate her. As soon as her butt hits the ground, I'd click, then I'd give her the treat, and then I would say the word sit. So the more you reward her for the things that you want, the more she's going to be inclined to want to do those things. We're going to get Coco in our sign up in our puppy class. She's too old for the classes, but I think if we put her with some very tiny little puppies, that's going to help her boost some self-esteem, as well as confidence, and help her develop some good social skills, which would really help her. Also, it helps expose her to other people, or she's a little bit distracted looking at the puppies. All right, Miss Coco, come here, sweetheart. Yes, I know. It's been a long day for me too. I screwed up my hip yesterday, so I'm old and now I'm starting to fall apart. Well, this is my buddy Coco. Remember, any questions that you have, message me. If you read something online that doesn't make sense, message me. If I don't hear from you, I assume that means everything's going great. So I want you to reach out if you have any questions or problems. All right, well, this is Coco, and this is Coco's roadmap to success. Remember, everything you do trains your dog, only sometimes you mean it. Right, Coco?